All right, pulled the head off. I'm gonna set the camera up here on the light and I'm gonna put the rings on. My pliers, where my ring pliers go. Yeah, using special ring pliers, okay? These expand the rings very, very nicely so you don't break them. Now remember, letters up. So this is the, let's see, what are we doing? This is the PTO side, the mag side still in the box, because that's the magneto side of the ring. So these rings go on the PTO piston. Make sure you got your grooves right. Make sure your arrow was pointed to the exhaust port. That's very important. And install your rings as so. The pliers really help. You can use your fingers and stuff, but I find that the ring pliers are the best. You just fit in the little grooves like that, and you squeeze like that, and it expands the ring so you can get it on the piston like so. Just like that, very simple. PTO side is on, good to go. Let's do the magneto side. Everything is falling back here. I really gotta clean this up. Let's see. Again, letters up. Facing the top. Like so. Oop, this one's a little tricky. Okay, very cool. I usually keep the rings expanded until I get them into the little pin locators. Another ring, like so. Just like that. All right, very good. Now, also very important to oil these. I have oil right here from, and this is two-stroke injector oil, okay? It's not synthetic oil, all right? It's regular conventional mineral oil. I'm using the mineral oil strictly, or the conventional oil strictly for engine braking. Once the piston rings and everything seat nice, I'll switch back over to the XPS synthetic, but this is standard XPS oil. It's the conventional, it's not the synthetic injector oil. So that's pretty important to point out. And you know, just be ginger with these parts. You have to oil them up real good. And also dump oil into the crank journals to give it a good startup lubrication. The two holes here on the sides, those go to the outer bearing races. I put oil in there, lay it along this lip just like this. And it'll follow suit and go down into the grooves that it's supposed to. Just like that. Throw the rest of the oil there, you know, little cup. Not much, just a little, give it something going till the oil pump winds. You're gonna bleed all of that stuff out and everything gets nice and lubricated. So piston rings are on, we're good. Now I'm gonna put the cylinder back on. It's very easy to do. I gotta put the base gasket on the jug. Just, you know, your fingers. You don't need a ring compressor. Just make sure you squeeze your rings together with your fingers, because the end of the cylinder is chamfered. It does have a starter lip on it, if you want to call it a starter lip. I'm going to put the base gasket back on.
Low power.
And that will do that. So, all right. I'm going to put this back together, and I'll give you a picture of it once it's painted. But that's basically, you know, it. I'm going to retorque everything. Head bolts, jug bolts, 30 foot-pounds. Molly coat, the undersides of the bolts. Loctite 242, all threads. Don't be chintzy with that stuff.
Low power.
And that's that. So we'll be back, and I'll show you finished product.